you can.
Temporary layoffs.
Good times.
Easy credit rip-offs.
Good times.
Scratching and surviving.
Good times.
Hanging in a jar.
Good times. Ain't we lucky we got them? Good times.
Mama says stay away from the TV. You'll get nothing out of it. Maria watches a lot of it. Hardly ever stops to eat or even piss. She's like a living, walking, talking TV guide. The characters are what she wants to be in life, but see, it goes deeper than that. You gotta go to her hood and enter her shack. You gotta consider the fact that Maria is a little black girl lost. No friends. So she looks to Monica, Chandler, Rachel and Ross, so no mama, she can't turn the TV off. No dad to talk her troubles to. So obviously she watches the Cosbys. Her father is now a doctor named Heathcliff Huxtable, and yeah, he's fake, but at least he's in her home every day, and whenever he hugs little Rudy, he truly hugs them both. No known cousins, so she has to borrow them. Little Ashley, baby Nikki, Hillary, and Carlton. And Aunt Vivian and an Uncle Phil. Said when she gets rich, she wants to have a butler named Jeffrey, so I guess she will. She's a girl, but still she can't relate to Boy Meets World, living like a savage kid lived. Will she remember the Wonder Years? She loves the TV shows about doctors. It's like ER whenever mother tells her to go scrub in the tub, a different soap opera. But the same general hospital, pitiful. Living out the days of our lives in fears. Maria knows we only got one life to live, and she right. The future is dim with no God and light. Scripted TV has become her reality. Mama told her reality doesn't always end, and happiness, in fact, is usually all bad when you fade to black. And yeah, I know it's pathetic how far from real life Maria is getting. But no one pays her any attention, so for better plot, she has to change her setting. Her mind is wasting from lack of appreciation, but at least when a favorite TV show goes off, it'll give her merit. For finally she'll see some type of credit.